Michelle just dropped shock admission in Hidden Vid confirming our worst fears, this will make you sick. So many of us believe that America got a great deal with President Donald Trump that it's easy to forget how it was before. Before President and Mrs. Trump we had 8 years of President and Mrs. Obama, and that was a different experience altogether. With the Obamas, there was constantly a fight going on, that didn't even need to be fought. Martin Luther King Jr. so famously said, "I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin but by the content of their character." This is what is supposed to be the dream of any person who wishes to eradicate racism, to create a world where color isn't even important, just something that you are, like tall, or short. But to the Obamas, race is all that they are. Despite the fact that Barack Obama was biracial, he considered himself to be a black man, and therefore the first black man to rule the White House. His wife was not biracial that anyone knows of, but 100% African American, and boy did she like to talk about it. And while there's nothing wrong with being content with who you are, it's encouraged even, she wasn't content. The Obamas seemed to constantly feel some sort of slight, even when there wasn't one. And because of that, they harassed the nation, day and night for 8 years about imagined aggressions and unfair treatment that just didn't exist. According to Michelle Obama, Black America was bound to come to their senses, they didn't have a choice, they had to support her husband. To listen to Michelle, she fought the odds to become anything while all of America tried to hold her back. We all know that everyone likes a good underdog story. So it makes sense that people talk about their hardships while on a campaign. But what nobody likes is that person who constantly makes their lives out to be worse than it is. Here's a fantastic example of that in an interview from 2008 while Barack was running against Hillary. "The thing that people seem to conveniently forget is that racism always hurts, no matter what direction it goes in. Yes, Black Americans have been discriminated against in the past. But today they're not the ones being cut down and blamed for everything. Today, not only have they regained equal footing, people like Mrs. Obama are looking to exploit that dark time to get a better chance at stepping on the necks of anyone they need to in order to get ahead." It would be nice to think that speeches like that are racially motivated, but the truth is that some people are just opportunists, and they'll use any leverage they need to in order to get where they're going. And if that's not enough for you, how about this speech that Mrs. Obama made for a group of graduates that no doubt inspired many to go on to become some of the nation's greatest social justice warriors of our day? It's brought to you courtesy of The Atlantic. Obama flared again as she addressed the lingering shadows of racism. She began with the individual, getting pulled over for driving while black, being watched ever so closely while shopping, having pedestrians cross the street to avoid you. Then she edged into the big P political. Maybe it's when the early voting location in your neighborhood just happens to be closed, or law after law is passed about the kind of ID you need to cast your vote. Maybe it's all those schools that, despite the laws, are still very much separate and unequal. Or the criminal justice system that still doesn't provide truly equal justice for far too many. Obama pled with the graduates not to meet such hurdles with rage or despair, but to take a page from Barack's playbook, as he says, "When they go low, I go high." And, whatever else you do, she said, vote. You can hashtag all over Instagram and Twitter, but those social media movements will disappear faster than a Snapchat if you're not also registered to vote, if you're not sending in your absentee ballots. State houses will continue to roll back voting rights and write discrimination into the law. We see it right here in Mississippi. Just 2 weeks ago, how swiftly progress can hurtle backwards, how easy it is to single out a small group and marginalize them for who they are or who they love, she said, referring to the state's new religious freedom law that gives legal protection to people who refuse to provide services based on a moral objection to gay marriage, out-of-wedlock sex, or transgender identity. "So we've got to stand side by side with all our neighbors," proclaimed Obama, "straight, gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, Muslim, Jew, Christian, Hindu, immigrant, Native American. Because the March for Civil Rights isn't just about African Americans. It's about all Americans. Teachers who didn't think that I was smart enough, and would call on the boys in class instead of the girls, even though the girls had better grades. People who thought a girl shouldn't have ambition, and they would ask my brother what career he planned to have but would ask me what kind of man I wanted to marry. As I got older, I found that men would whistle at me or make comments about how I looked as I walked down the street as if my body were their property, as if I were an object to be commented on instead of a full human being with thoughts and feelings of my own. I began to realize that the hopes I had for myself were in conflict with the messages I was receiving from people around me, messages that said that, as a girl, my voice was somehow less important, that how my body looked was more important than how my mind worked, that being strong and powerful and outspoken just wasn't appropriate or attractive for a girl.